Hello everyone, it's Andrea Mengucci, keep recording Modern, today with Living End. Living End is a deck that has been in Modern since forever, and the decklist has pretty much been the same. The deck just top 80 starts hitting game Dallas, so let's see how it behaves in this Modern meta game. The decklist is has been very simple and very easy. You have a lot. You have a very few free slots. The free slots are Jungle Weaver, which I'm not sure if it's cool or not. It's just a 2-mana cycle, nothing special. Avalanche Rider is great against like the more fair decks. It's another Fulminator Mage effect that helps you taking time and make your Living End better. Also, two Simic Spirit Guides, only two, because I feel that Simic Spirit Guide is great in the against the fast decks, but it's very bad against the slow decks. So I think two it's the correct number, and that's what he was playing. He was also playing three Fairy Macabre. Fairy Macabre is a card that is great in some matchups, but in some other, you don't see the necessary, like you don't think it's necessary, but in reality, then Fairy Macabre is just a great card. So basically, Fairy Macabre does that you cast your first Living End with either Demonic Dread or Violent Outburst, and then your opponent is gonna have some creatures in the graveyard. At that point, if you really needed to cast a second Living End, for example, your opponent just kills you all your creatures with, let's say, Wrath of God, or just a couple of removal spells, Snapcaster, Path of Exile, and stuff, you can just exile the creature that first went in the graveyard, and then just Living End again, and they will not have those creatures. And that's a thing that really happens against, let's say, Scavenging Ooze. Scavenging Ooze is very annoying, because sometimes you just have to Living End it away with not that much of a creature in play, so they're just gonna kill your creatures in play, and you're gonna have empty board, and they're gonna have their Scavenging Ooze in the graveyard. So that's where Fairy Macabre kind of shines. It's also great, of course, against Dredge, Living End, Snapcaster, Mage, and stuff. The rest of the deck is pretty straightforward. For those of you who don't know the combo, you just cycle with a lot of cyclers, and then you just cast a Demonic Dread or Violent Outburst that basically does nothing but cascade into your Living End, which is gonna reanimate your whole graveyard. Sideboard has three Shriek Maw, good against creatures, good against Scavenging Goose. Three Ricochet Trap, which is great against blue decks. Remember that this doesn't only, let's say, counter blue deck, it can also redirect a Path to Exile in case your opponent goes Snapcaster Path to Exile, and that's a thing that came up very often against the Jeskai. Ingachiwa, good against Relic of Progenitus. Be reminded that Gravedigger's Cage doesn't do anything against you, so don't kill it. And if you have it in the sideboard, don't board it against Living End. For Brindleboar, because the burn is a very bad matchup, so you really want your boars, and then you'll be able to reanimate them, you know, gain 8 life sometimes might be enough to make the matchup good again. Slaughter Games, the guy was playing 2 Anger of the Gods, and I feel that Anger of the Gods isn't a card that Living End wants, because your opponent is never gonna overextend, because you have basically 8 Wrath Effects in your deck. That's what I wanted to say, sorry. So you don't need extra. On the other hand, Slaughter Games really wins certain matchups like Ad Nauseam or Scapeshift or whatever. We'll see. I just wanted to try it out. Another consideration was Blood Moon, but I guess we have very few lands, so we have a few basics, so sometimes it can hurt us as well. So let's see this, how it goes.